What's up, freaks? Your pal Al here, and today is day two of Momentum. I'm creeping through Disney Springs, 7 o'clock in the morning, and Disney Springs is closed, by the way. Nothing but workers. Without further ado, let's freak out.
Please stand clear of the doors.
Hey, John. Early enough for you?
It's too early. I was up since 12:30 doing the Give Kids the World thing, which was really successful.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much.
Awesome.
Thank you
very much.
You're welcome.
Let's get in there. Seems to be the morning ritual before the meeting.
You need it.
Yeah, you really do.
So they were saying that at the Give Kids the World.
Looks like we're playing Scrabble today. Have to see what this is about. Interesting. Everything's all set up and everybody's getting settled. I'll see you in a few. Time to learn something.
I did it almost 10 years ago. It started my business. And like I said yesterday, I love giving back. So I want to help any of you guys that are wondering what that next step is. Hopefully today can give you some inspiration. How many of us got something great yesterday out of the talks that they heard? How many of us, by showing hands? All right, now how many of us did something about it? A famous quote that I always live by is, inspiration and ideation is nothing without execution. So make sure that you guys are taking what you learn here and actually doing something with it. That's the most important part. We work with over 150 NCAA colleges, and I think that coming from a small brand, we've never taken equity, we've never given investment. All of this has been bankrolled from me from day one. And you have to be, you have to have the, what makes you different. And to me, when it was, I'm in a sea of people, most colleges have 28 SOC licensees, right? They already work with 28 SOC licensees. So what can I do to be different? And every single trade show that we would go to that had college licensing there, we would memorize the faces of the athletic directors.
How did you finance the early part of the startup, and then how did you go for a line of credit without being formalized in that way?
Still don't have a line of credit. Didn't have a credit card until I was 27. Like my uncle, he's like a hermit, lives in a shack in California. He always told me like, don't get a credit card. So I didn't have a credit card. It actually hurts me because when I try to build my company and I have to build credit, right, no credit is worse than bad credit, you know, which is crazy.
I know.
But starting the company, it was really off of buying my first pair of socks at $12 or being able to extend my resources in the basketball world and get those socks for free. But when I started to build the business, it was buying that first pair of socks at $12, buying the dip dive for $4, turning that $16 into a $40 sock, taking that $40, buying more socks with it, and just never ending cycle of putting my money back into it. We're a big company, and I just bought my house for the first time, and we're almost 10 years in. I've always put myself and my personal wants behind the company's actual needs.
That was a very great presentation, and I actually had a talk with him, and we made you a tour of his complex there. If you guys would like to see that, please let us know in the comments below. But we are definitely going to do that because it's a Florida-based company and we freak out about everything in Florida. So be sure to check that out soon.
We heard about this thing called podcasting, and I literally asked Jeeves what a podcast was. And it was a very sort of weird, complicated, you know, I remember all the podcasting. It had this very weird sort of description of what a podcast was, and it was fascinating to me when I started to understand. Because, one, I suck at typing. I say this all the time. My mom made me take Latin in high school instead of typing because I knew I was going to be a lawyer. For some reason, she thought Latin would be helpful. But she's like, you'll have a secretary. You'll be fine. I should have taken typing. So I stick at typing. And what I heard about podcasting and what the medium offered in terms of the power of the spoken word being so much more powerful than anything you could write, I was fascinated. That's how, what was Mouse, everybody listen to Mouse Tunes way back when? Wow. And yet you, yeah, we're still friends. It was amazing back then, this idea of putting your voice out there, and it was very, very complicated, and it wasn't in iTunes, and you had to hand code your RSS feed, and you, there was the only way to consume it, there was an app called like Lemon or something to try and like that. It was super convoluted and super confusing to do, but I think I recognize that there are things that podcasts can do that you literally cannot do in any other type of medium. And more importantly, I think now, 15 years later in 2019, we still have not even scratched the surface of the potential, more importantly, the reach of podcasting. I've seen podcasting come, go, live, die, be reborn. It's the renaissance, it's the death knell of podcasting, it's the phoenix of podcasting. I still think there's massive potential, and more importantly, opportunity for you to grow and build your business and brand. So I wanted somebody to come in to talk about the power of this medium, and it's somebody who, like all the other speakers, has walked the walk and built his podcast, built his business around something he loves. So sit back, relax, don't, not too much, don't fall asleep, and please welcome Mark Bologna.
So as Lou mentioned, you're gonna see a lot of themes here that others have talked about, and I hope that it builds on what we've done the last day and a half. But the power of podcasting to me is a very real thing. And as you're sitting there, some of you maybe are interested in starting a podcast, some of you maybe do, some of you have no interest. For those of you that have no interest, what I hope to do is sort of challenge you in ways to take the ideas out of the power of podcasting and use them in whatever medium you use.
This might come as a shock to you. Don't believe everything you read on the internet. It's not all true. Sometimes I understand showing proof of concept and having the social proof in terms of what you are doing, but a lot of times you are not getting all facts. When somebody says they're making $100,000 a month, maybe they're not showing you exactly what they're spending a month to make that, and what maybe that $100,000 of income really means and looked like. The real work starts when all those things are created, right? And then you have to, and they don't just sit back and just, you see this all the time, man. These guys posting screenshots of all the money that they're getting in every day as they're laying on the beach with their beautiful freaking supermodels and cocktails. That's not how it works at all. At least not for me.
I say hi. Just say hi.
You go, hey, that looks good.
Yeah.
That looks real good. I'm going to go get some too right now. Wow, look at that. Yeah, I got to go get some. All right, thank you.
Best part of momentum. They feed you. They feed you.
Oh, cakes and pies.
Any of y'all.
And now we eat.
The transparency, there are no bad, stupid, or silly questions. Because this is going to help you sort of move the needle and turn the page and take what you're doing to the next level. So please welcome Scott Cornelius.
You can cover it through that W-2 and not pay quarterly estimates. It's based on the full picture of your year-end tax situation. And actually, the IRS treats W-2 withholding more favorably than quarterly estimates. So if you do have the ability to pay it through your spouse's W-2, I recommend that.
To the top 10 tools you can and should use. But hi, my name is Lou Mundell. Happy to have you here. Okay, never leave me today. I tried to come up with a random number. I don't know exactly where I ended up. This is where, who actually read the questionnaire before they got it? I told you to bring a tool. Who brought a tool or a resource with them?
So good to take care of.
So Lou wants us to fill out these postcards with three things on the back. You see my three things on the back. Three goals that we want to achieve in the next 60 days. And then we're going to hand this back to him today, and in 60 days he's going to mail it to us, and we're going to see if we actually accomplished it. So you guys can help me on this, you know, if you want to.
Yeah, the biggest thing is just figuring out.
In fact, I'd really like you to help me on this. I'm going to leave this on the screen for a few seconds so you can. All right, that's enough.
Well, we talked about a lot of different things and some of the goal setting, some of the things I wanted you to challenge yourself with. And I started off the entire weekend with a single word that I also had you get up, because I said you are the first speaker and I wanted you to introduce yourself, right? It was the who, what, and why. Not only tell me what you do, but why you are here. So now I want to bring that back full circle. Challenge you again. I want you to stand up and share with us one thing, right? The one thing could be the one thing that you learned, your one big takeaway, one person that you met, one goal that you have, one thing that you're going to change, like right now. It could be one person you want to thank. I know some of you have pushed each other, right, to come or to come this year or past years. So I want you to share. You look so nervous, like I'm coming directly to you first, right? Don't you know me by now? If you look nervous, like I'm like a teacher, I'm looking at you first, right? I want you to share your one thing. It could be whatever is meaningful to you.
I think I learned not to take no for an answer. We all have fears, and as I was telling Connor, no is just that's the worst case scenario. And if that's the worst case scenario, then just keep going. And we learned from Steve yesterday that he was told no for 3.5 years before he was finally told yes. So that was an eye-opener.
This is family. A lot of you know that Friday night my son was injured severely in the spine at a football game. And I had so many of you come up to me and just, you know, a way to say, is he okay? Some of you prayed with me. Some of you were, I don't get that at other conferences. I don't get that at other groups. I don't get that at work. I don't get it at home. But the thing is, that's what's important, because as we all leave here, this is my fourth year. This is where I energize, as Pete said. It's hard if you don't have the family. Don't expect it to go much further. But if you stay in the family, in the hub, and connected, expect great things.
What this weekend really is about is my friends that I've met through the 4 years, friends that I've met this year, and then it's the folks that are going to be in the hub, and the encouragement when you're having a bad day. And this is why I come back every year. And it's for the content, because it's always top notch, but it's, I hate it. It's because of everybody here, and it's because of you.
It's about believing that I deserve the people that choose to watch what I put out, and so that's my next goal, and you've all kind of helped me get there, so thank you for all your help.
I'm Al Corey. I'm your pal Al on Florida Freaks and also the founder of Al Corey Productions LLC. I came here for the free lunch. I mean, I'm just being completely honest. No, my biggest takeaway actually was what many of you have already said, self-worth, figuring out who you are and how much you're worth. That's big to me. Because for a while there, you know, I went 3 or 4 years with my older company without even charging a single person.
And I did it because I just didn't know how to charge them. I mean, you know, I did it because I loved putting photography out there. I loved making photos for people. And I loved their expression on their face when I gave it to them. But I never really learned how to acquire the knowledge of being able to evaluate myself with how much my craft was worth and what I have to offer and put on the table. So I appreciate that. Thank you very much. And I also appreciate the tools that you provided us in order for us to move forward and everything. So thank you so much. As far as who I'm happy that I met here, it's everyone who's sitting down right now. I really appreciate you guys inviting me and taking me in. And I'm really working hard for that white box.
Every table that I sat at, I felt like I was with a family, and it felt nice. And I know it's really Lou's family, but it's nice to be here with you and being with all of you. I took away a lot. People think like I have it together. I do not. So I will change things too, but this is a really nice thing, and it's a recharge of batteries, even for me. I did a lot here, so I will do things and change things. My one thing is making a YouTube live show, something I didn't do. Wednesdays at 7:30 is the time. I really hope he lets me return, because there is no doubt that I will come back to the next one.
I tell you to ask for help when it's do as I say, not as I do, because I'm awful at it, but I'm also incredibly grateful for it. It sometimes takes a lot for me to ask for help. Very, very, very uncomfortable, obviously, asking for it, even when it's thrust upon me. Just seems like I'm flying there. You cannot stop me. I'm coming. So thank you. And even in all of you, have helped me. All of you have helped me in ways that you are unaware of. Whether it's by being here, your friendship, your support, a message, a card, sometimes it's a look when you see I might just need it. I built the clubhouse, I organized Momentum, but you are the ones that populate it and make it happen is not a lie, it is true. You have all impacted my life in remarkable and profound ways, and I'm grateful beyond words for you for a lot of different reasons.
Into it, I kind of forced myself to like regroup mentally on where I am.
Because he's got a coin.
Yep. So can you tell him to order a bag? How long does it take?
Thank you very much.
The bags are ready.
Okay, cool.
I'm excited about that.
Yeah,
this is great. You can help me with that.
I love it. So then I can
John, I need to give you a hug. All right.
We're wrapping it up. It's been a fantastic weekend, and I really thank Mr. Lou Mangiello for bringing me in here and showing me the ropes and giving me some tips and tools on how to improve the business. It's been a blast. I really appreciate it. And if you think about doing Momentum, check out everything. Check out the site. Make sure that you get into everything, because it's a good thing to get into if you really want to improve not only yourself, but also improve the business that you've been working hard on all this time. You will definitely walk away with a lot of new goals, new tools, and new objectives in order to accomplish what you started out doing in the first place, and that's succeed. If you enjoyed this video, if you enjoyed this series, then give both videos a big fat thumbs up. And if this is your first time here, remember to subscribe and notify so you see more videos just like this one. This is your pal Al. Had our freak out. Learned a lot. Now it's time to go home, utilize these, and then pass out. We'll see you real soon.
I'm gonna be famous on them YouTubes.